I'm Dr. Amy Mosig Way. I'm an archaeologist and a lecturer at the University of Sydney and the Australian Museum. And I specialise in community-centred archaeology, stone artefact analysis and excavation, particularly of rock shelters like the one we have behind us. So here we have Dargan Shelter, which is one of Australia's most significant high altitude sites. So the reason that Dargan Shelter is so significant is because in our project, we unearthed stone artefacts and fireplaces from 20,000 years ago. And this is an amazing period in the history of Australia because 20,000 years ago, we were in the middle of an ice age. So the Blue Mountains that we have around us here today, covered in beautiful trees, but back then, no trees. It was completely frozen over in winter and the ground was still frozen in summer. So for a long time, the thinking was that people wouldn't have spent much time up in the mountains. It would have been a place to get through quickly. But what our project showed is that people were up here in the peak of the cold period and they were spending time up here. One of the really interesting finds that we had was that we found that the artefacts that people were leaving here had come from the north and the south of this site, so up to 70 kilometres away. And what this means is that people were travelling along the mountain range during the peak of the Ice Age. And the really important story that this tells us is that this landscape that we're standing in, this cultural landscape, now has to be considered as the most significant periglacial landscape in Australia for deep time cultural history.
Hi, I'm Wayne Brennan. I'm a First Nation mentor at the University of Sydney Archaeology Department. My background is I'm a Gomeroi man. This site's very, very important because we have not only cultural material going back to the last glacial maximum, but we have a whole story, a unique story that is continuous. Very rarely do you get deposits where they aren't disturbed. These deposits here have been fantastically intact and they tell an amazing story of people being here during the last glacial maximum above the snow line. People would have used this just as an overnight or maybe two nights stay, not very long here, but more importantly that they would come back here regularly. And they're on their way to go do ceremony up in the upper parts of the mountains, around Mount Wilson, Mount Irvine, as we know, a big boreal ground there. So it's a waypoint for their journey to a very, very important ceremony, which is the Burbung ceremony.
This is a really special site for our people because it's a place where our people and many other people met over a really long period of time. It's been a blessing, really, because a lot of those areas have been protected. But we still need to spend a lot of time piecing our stories all back together right across this whole landscape.
But to heal our people is to heal our country. To heal our country is to heal our story and our site.
And these places need to hear our language too.